Hello, hello, hello. In this video, I will be giving you a quick review of Northern Stranglethorn to tell you whether it is worth leveling your character here or not. You can find timestamps in the video description below. You will see how long it took me to complete the zone from start to finish, and based on that, the amount of experience I got per minute. This video is recorded from Alliance perspective. Sorry, Horde. Because I leveled through the zone myself, all the information is fresh and legit. The zone is a tough cookie. There's lots of XP to reap from it, but it takes a lot of time to finish, and that's generally not worth it at all. Northern Stranglethorn earns a 3.1 out of 5 from me. From my run, having played a Shadow Priest, I managed to finish Northern Stranglethorn in 1 hour, 40 minutes, and 7 seconds. This was my starting level, and my final level. I had War Mode on, 100% mount speed, and all heirlooms equipped. Based on all of that, I was earning 4.51 XP per minute. This translates to earning one level roughly every 24 minutes. To achieve the best results, I recommend doing Northern Stranglethorn if your character is between levels 25 to 35. The reason behind this is scaling. The green graph shows how many levels are possible to achieve in Northern Stranglethorn, depending on your character's level, of course. This brown graph shows what your XP per minute gain can be like, again, depending on your character's level. However, the graphs only take quests into account, not mobs killed. Therefore, your final results should always be better than what the graph shows. As you can see, my actual values were much higher. Northern Stranglethorn gave me 4.5 levels, which is 33.43% more than what the green graph shows. I had 4.51% XP per minute gain, which is 33.43% more than what the brown graph shows. Now that you know the statistics, let's talk about the pros and cons. As I said before, if your character is within the level 25 to 35 range, Northern Stranglethorn is a good zone to do. The quest lines are fairly linear, however, there are 3 storylines in total, which all happen at the same time, and they are not tailored to work well with one another. What this means is that your map can get easily cluttered with quests, and you might not be sure which one to do first. Even if you do know the best optimal route, it still takes a lot of time to do. Most quest items dropped by mobs have a below average drop rate. 3 quests involve killing panthers, mobs which are in stealth, that is generally annoying. Only 7 rare mobs, out of which I kill 3 during my own run. Knowing when to use your hearthstone is tricky, as the only place where you can use it in is 4th Livingston. So, when to use your hearthstone is something I leave to your own better judgment, I'm sorry. Personally, I used it when I was far away from Rebel Camp, for example. But I had a flight path in 4th Livingston, so I hearthstoned there, talked to the flight master, and let the bird carry me all the way back to Rebel Camp. It made things quicker. But in all due seriousness, I do not recommend leveling here. Maybe I was unlucky, who knows. Maybe you'd rather re-experience the nostalgic feeling of playing in Stranglethorn Vale, the feeling of walking by the old shadow of what once used to be the 20-man raid of Zul'Gurub, or maybe you simply enjoy leveling in jungle environments. The choice, in the end, is ultimately yours. Thanks for watching. Share, like, dislike, subscribe, unsubscribe, have fun leveling, or at least try to have fun leveling. Until another time.